going into the forest, so I guess it was the session before, you were attacked by some undead monster. This girl ran up to you and said, "Oh my god, my village is being destroyed by creatures. Please help." And when you were attacked by this banshee thing, she ran off in the woods in the hope to pursue her and find out where she went. You followed her to a destroyed tower. Upon entering said tower, obviously she was outside, you guys brought her in the car, so on and so forth. But you decided to explore the tower a little bit, and you went inside the tower to be met with some weird, creepy, globule-type creatures with, you know, a thousand eyes and a whole other kind of weird situation. With them moaning and other strange events, and yeah, you guys bailed. And instead decided to continue on to the city. The village, sorry. So, as you arrive at the village, you came up with a plan as to how you were going to approach the situation. You came in from the east, you went to the cellars, and you immediately noticed that no one was really in the town aside from a few zombie-like creatures. Except, after sitting there for about half an hour, a cultist came out of one of the buildings, dragging with him a villager of some kind. He started to interrogate him, and that is when you guys rushed in. Realistically, actually after Antime has put a bolt in the guy's chest. And then you guys ran in, killing zombies and skeletons and such, until three very, very large horned skeletons with giant great axes came out of an alley led by one of these kind of strange dudes in black cloaks. Mr. Black Cloak Man was dispatched quickly again, and the other three were dispatched honorably. I don't think anyone died, unless I, like, totally missed something, but I don't believe so. And you guys kind of wrecked these things, so that that was good. That's where we are right now, in a more or less empty village.
I almost died.
Yeah, Maple had a nap while I was fighting those skeletons.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, whatever. I took two of them. You just played around with the one.
Until you had a nap, then I had to...
Okay, so you guys are all standing in the village here. You see Antimaeus start going among the bodies to...
What kind of quality are the their weapons there, those at great axes?
I will let you know in a second. So, the great axes are nothing special. They're big hunks of steel that have been crafted into... They're about as suitable as the state of the armor and such that the big skeleton things were wearing too, which is essentially non-existent. So,
I wonder how much a blacksmith would pay for that kind of stuff, because if you meld that down and you could make a whole bunch of weapons with it.
True. Yeah, very possibly.
Well, you might want to grab those then.
Right.
And, well, you use...
Let's dig up some room in the cart.
Alright, Jordan, on the two guys that you loot there, the cultists, you, aside from their robes, they have, like, four copper pieces total between the two of them, and two curved blades. Otherwise, they have nothing on them.
I'll strip them down in a thorough search, and then I'll call to someone to help me drag the farther body to the pile of bodies I'm sure we're making somewhere.
I can go offer some one-armed assistance. I'm missing a part of my shoulder still.
Y'all can help with that.
Oh god, it's so heavy, I can't do this.
Just gonna sit
yeah, you're lifting a great.
The fuck down. I can't heal you anyway, I use that is what I am gonna do.
You're gonna sit down, didn't you say?
Yeah, I'm just sitting where I am. I'm fucking hurt. You guys move around bodies and stuff.
Does anybody else need healing at all? I can't heal Maple. I already used the healer's kit on her, so.
I'm definitely going to need some sort of medical attention at some point soon.
Okay. I'm going to walk on over to you and wrap up your wounds and put some, I don't know, dirt in your shoulder.
Yeah, that's my trick.
Rub some lotion on his skin.
I don't have medicine, so.
I got a shoulder again. but hey, it works. What are we as people if not that? Jordan, can you roll me an investigate check, please? if you have it. If you don't, intelligence.
23.
Okay. Yeah, you don't find anything else of note on them.
You get 9 hit points back.
I get that.
Nice.
Thank you, thank you.
Is there no tattoos or anything?
No.
No markings? They're not blonde? Blue-eyed?
No blonde blue eyes.
Okay. I will leave that alone, because I'm sure everyone else will help with the piling of bodies, and I'll flip alias for copper and just say thanks for the help.
Thanks, man.
And then
buy yourself half an ale.
I will head deeper into the, like, the city, I guess. Like, how big is this village?
Tiny.
I thought we were in the center of it.
I'll start doing loops then to try to, like, stealth, to try to hear if I hear any more zombies or any villagers that are still alive or anything.
Okay. We should be able to loot the whole town before the villagers come back.
Oh, yes. To put into perspective, it took you guys 2 rounds of sprinting to get from the edge of town to the center of it, just about. So that kind of speaks to how large this place is. It's tiny. Yes. So yeah, you can definitely kind of explore around and do a couple laps. Do you want to give me a perception? And or if you don't have perception, wisdom, as well as a stealth check, please.
20 for perception and 12 for stealth.
Once I'm done healing up Alias, I'm going to let him know that I'm going to go back and grab a Helen in the cart.
And I'm going to stay where I am. Is it possible to take a short rest right here? Because I'm not helping anyone.
Oh yeah, you can 100% take a short rest. As long as you guys are willing to stick around for about an hour, go for it.
I'll kind of stand guard. I mean, I'll do stuff around, but I mean, I'll keep an eye on her. But other than looting and packing off bodies.
While we're kind of hanging around, I'm going to try and see if I can get any of my arrows back.
Okay.
If possible, maybe.
All right.
I think I fired 3.
Yeah, actually, you're able to recover 2.
Woo!
The one you can't recover is the one that was shot right for direct skull, the thing. That thing embedded itself quite well, and yeah. Yeah.
I'll leave that one as a trophy.
Your personalized arrows of St. Elias was here.
So, anything in particular you're looking for there, Jordan?
I'll be listening for any shuffling of zombie-like undead creatures, and then trying to spot specifically the villager I let get away, and or any other villagers or, you know, lights and houses or anything like that.
Are you willing to spend a fair bit of time? I mean, obviously the village isn't big, but are you, like, taking a couple laps of it? Are you going through buildings, or are you just kind of moving throughout the alleys?
I'll be stealth, so I'll be taking my time jumping from shadow to shadow and listening and looking.
All right, Pi, you get back to the cart, and Helen is still there, and when she sees you, she goes, "You're alive, but where are the others? Oh, gods, they didn't die, did they?
No, calm down.
Is it just you and me?
I managed to save them all, don't worry.
Oh, thank the gods. So does that mean my village is restored? Can I go back now?
I'm afraid I have some bad news. Your husband may be dead in a ditch. Oh, I'm sorry. I've been... yeah, there's some bad stuff going on back in town. There is a lot of undead. I don't...
He might be dead?
Yeah, maybe. Well, we haven't searched yet. I mean...
Oh, okay. I was pretty sure he was taken with the others, so... But if you had found him and somehow defined his face from the depths of your mind...
Well...
Then perhaps I would have been woeful, but there's still hope.
Well, we might find his face severed, I don't know.
It's just...
I mean, we found everybody was taken. They were all mutilated. He's dead. Just let's move
on. Yeah. We did clear out most of them, I think. I figured you could come back and help search for your husband, or...
Oh, okay.
It should be safe now.
So she'll... She'll get in the cart, and I'm assuming you're going to drive the cart on back.
Fall asleep halfway.
Yeah. Wake up in the middle of another forest by another ruined tower. She's dead on the side of the road.
Just, fuck, not again!
All the horses are gone. Hey guys, this is how I found it when I got back.
Can't blame me for that one.
Happens every month.
I think the gods just don't want us to have horses. Okay, so by the time you get back, and man, you'll have kind of finished up your search by the time he can see reapproaching. So, you didn't find anything of note until near the end of your kind of journey through here. So, what you will notice is that all of the undead creatures, or what you would assume were undead because of their general appearance, are all dead. Like, actually dead now. After the skeleton fell, there were a few of the things still shambling around, and they had fallen immediately to the ground after the skeletons had died. It appears that the rest of the undead in the town have also succumbed to the same fate. So, yeah, there's like piles of bones lying here and there, other undead that were in the village, you know, zombies lying on the ground, but, you know, at a glance, they don't appear to be making any effort to get back up. It isn't until you've made almost a complete circle around the town, until you definitely hear a noise from the top floor of a two-story building that appears to be perhaps some kind of storefront, but it's not clearly identifiable.
From this vantage point, can I get to a position where I can see any of the others where I had left them?
The group?
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, you could kind of bend around the corner of this building and give them a wave.
Yep, I'll do that.
So it's right around this time that Pi is also arriving as well. So the four of you will see Antimaeus kind of poke around a corner and give you guys sort of a wave or a signal. Yep. And he's in a building not more than, you know, 200 feet, 150 feet away from me right now.
I guess I'll get up and I'll start heading over that way.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I'll do the same. I'm going to assume it was kind of like a stealthy, hey guys, you should sneak over here signal. Or just, shh, but run.
And I'll also have sword drawn. Alright.
Just, you know.
It's an important note to make to me. I've punished you with that before.
You've punished me for that before.
Oh, alright. Okay, so you all get to where Antimaeus is.
I'll whisper for Almagar to come with me to the front and someone stay here at the back. There's someone in the second story. I guess we'll try to talk to them. And then if they try to flee, you guys in the back can just tackle them or something.
For me, I'll kind of find a position around this door.
I'll stay at the back.
I'll just sneak inside. I'll just follow Animaeus, like pretend like as he's stealthy, I'll be like, falling, like, oh, that's how you be stealthy, you know?
I get it now.
You try not to make noise.
Almagar and Antimaeus go around to the front. The rest of you are hanging out in the back?
I'm going to stay with Helen.
Okay.
Go loitering now.
Okay. But Maple and Ilias will stay in the back?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So, you guys reach the front. You guys are staying in the back. How would you like to breach? The door is shut in both cases.
I'm just going to tell Almagar to knock and do his most welcoming greeting.
Try it.
If it doesn't work, I can just knock on the door. Yeah, I'll knock on the door.
Okay.
Not really, really loud, but I'll give it like a regular friendly knock.
Sure. Okay. The noises you were hearing upstairs immediately come to a halt. And it's just like silent after the knock.
I'll give Almagar a nudge.
Is the door locked? I'll try the door as soon as it's locked.
It is not.
Okay. I'll open the door, but I'll just push it open and then kind of make sure I'm on the side in case someone's like firing something out the door or something.
Okay.
And if no one fires something right away, I'll go on to it.
Alright. No projectiles fire out of the door when you open it up. it appears in first glance to be, like I said, kind of a shop. It's like sort of a general, what you would guess to be a general wares type store. But most of the hooks that would have been holding certain items and most of the crates and that sort of thing have just been completely ravaged. There's like a couple torn leaves hanging from hooks and that sort of thing, but otherwise the place has been looted through and through. Okay. While the building looked put together on the outside, not so much on the inside.
Okay. I'll just kind of yell inside, greetings! Anybody need assistance in here?
Someone. Can you give me, a charisma check or Scott?
13! That's good for me.
Yeah. You hear a call from upstairs say,
hello? Are they gone? Please tell me you're not them!
They're gone, the coast is clear.
What? How do I trust you? Oh, damn. I shouldn't have spoke.
Is this Sandal from Dragon Age?
Need assistance, or are you good? Your shop doesn't look too good downstairs here.
I don't know nothing about who took what was in the shop, and I don't need any asses of any kind.
Oh, man.
Definitely not your sisters.
I'll start sneaking up a stairway if I can find one.
Sure.
And I'll kind of rummage and look around downstairs. Is there anything I can take?
Yeah, it's a very, very simple little building. It's kind of got a counter up in the front. You can see a door right behind the counter that you can clearly see the door that would be the back. Kind of through it. There's probably like another little hall in there somewhere that would store a few items. And then the back wall is... it's kind of two-layered, and when you look around the other layer, you can see the staircase that clearly ascends. So yeah, you can certainly...
So we can probably hear them pretty well from outside?
Yeah. So you two can definitely hear this conversation going on.
I'm gonna see if I can open the back door and kind of walk in.
The back door is unlocked as well. So, Almagar, you will see directly in front of you the back door open and Alias head poke through.
Okay. All right. Throw my hat. No.
Demons! You wear his face, but you can ask him.
Stairs, they're back.
He was around the back of the building.
And then I'll stick around the back, but just kind of hanging out downstairs.
The guy calls down again and says,
well, if you is who you say you is, and you are nice people, you should just leave me be.
And he's trying to act all tough. Some weird accent he's putting on.
The rest of your village might need some assistance as well, if you're able to help them out at all.
I don't know anything about that, sir. No.
Oh, you don't live here? Or
no, I do. Yeah, I do. I'll just,
you know anyone else in this town?
I don't know where they are, and I'm not really the adventuring type, if you catch me, river.
I'll sneak up the stairs.
Okay. Alright. You sneak up, downstairs. And it's pretty dark in the stairs, and you peer around the corner of the top of the stairs. You can see the guy, like, poking his head through the door. He doesn't even seem to notice you, even though you're, like, you know, 6 or 7 steps away from him. And he's just looking, like, freaked out as all hell, staring down the stairs.
I'm gonna poke him in the eye with my finger, and then kick the door open.
He's gonna sneak around
the door. But I'll, like, poke his eye out.
Go. Yeah. He's like, oh! And he falls backwards on the ground. You open up the door, and the guy's on his back, and he's, like, scooting away from you. He says,
please, sir, I meant no offense. Just leave me be.
Is it the same guy from earlier?
It's the guy that was in the center of the town, yeah, that the other guy was interrogating.
I already told your comrades I know nothing. Nothing.
Which comrades do you speak of? The ones in black?
You know, they're dressed kind of like you, wearing all dark colors and such. I know nothing. Just leave me alone.
How many of them were there?
I don't know. There were lots. Victor?
Can you count? How many fingers am I holding up?
Well, plenty more than I've got coins in me purse. Nothing to steal from me, sir.
Okay, good. That's established. What's this room look like, Alex? Is it just kind of a bedroom?
It looks like the private living quarters of whoever probably ran the shop. There's a very simple straw bed, one dresser that's all been pulled open, and a small desk with an old book on it. That's about it.
Ooh. I'll take the book.
Okay.
And then I'll hand it to him.
Okay.
And be like, we'll teach you to read. Now come with us.
It's just, why do I need to know to read? Don't mind me asking. Sir, gentlemen.
Well, if you think I'm a sire or a gentleman, we need to teach you a few things. You have to come see our master now.
I believe I already spoke with him. I already signed no nothing.
Alagar!
Alright, I'll come. No need to be get grabbing.
He'll lead you downstairs.
Yeah.
Or
that whole time I was actually searching the downstairs, did I see anything out of place? I mean, other than, everything being out of place, but anything that didn't belong, or...
Do you want to give me an investigate check, please? If you don't have investigate, give me intelligence.
Probability either. 11.
Alright. Yeah, nothing too out of place, just, yeah. Nothing more, at least, than, like, what you said, the place is kind of wrecked. Alright, so he takes one look at you, Almagar, and his eyes just go wide, and he says,
well, I don't think you'd be lying about not being the others, but my, you're a big fellow.
I'll slap the back of his head.
Oh!
Mind your P's and Q's.
Oh.
Don't drop the book.
Oh, no. No, I would never drop the P's and Q's.
Exactly. Let's go take you to our master.
Alright. This isn't your master.
Of course not.
Oh my.
Your master must be
12 feet tall. If he's to work with such a man.
Where are you bringing this guy? Like to the front door or to the back?
Whatever's fast to get to Pythagoras.
Do I recognize this guy at all?
Yeah, so as soon as Anime starts leading to the back, you recognize this guy as Jonathan. And Jonathan's not a very smart man.
So he probably doesn't recognize me then.
No, actually, he looks at you and says, oh, Master Alias, are these your friends?
Let's just keep heading outside, Jonathan.
Alright. Oh my, if I had known that you were their company, I wouldn't have been so afeard.
Where do I know him from?
So, this guy, he's a good worker, but he's definitely a manual laborer. He's like a woodcutter from the town.
Oh, okay.
He doesn't run the business or anything else, he just gets hired by the guy who owns kind of the mill to actually do work for him.
He's the guy that people pick to lift heavy shit.
Yeah, and he's recruited you a few times. Because for whatever reason, he believes that the deeper into the forest you get, the better the wood quality.
Sure.
No one argues with the guy. So there's been a couple times where he'll be like, go to Copper, and he'll think he's like giving you like some huge money, and you being the nice person you are will still lead him into the forest anyways to find the perfect tree.
A Jonathan.
Which is generally you just leading him back around the edge of the forest, but he doesn't realize it.
He thinks it's a long trek?
Yeah, exactly. So yes, that's Jonathan.
Jonathan from here.
Also, I don't know if you ever asked this question, but you don't recognize Helen, just as a point.
I think I did.
Okay, good.
Yeah, when the girls first ran at us.
Yeah, okay, alright. So, anyways, so Johnson looks at you and goes, oh, better company now, and then looks at Maple and is like,
boy, you have untamed company, Alias.
I'm also just, like, covered in my own blood, too.
Yeah, exactly.
So I'm just like, I'm standing there, I'm just staring. I'm not even gonna say anything.
My eyes.
Is this your master?
As he looks at you, Alias.
I'll keep slapping the back of his head every time he stops the stairs. And then I'll just keep telling him to continue. Not hard, just kind of like a, you idiot.
He still overreacts, thinking you're going to kill him or something.
And I'll make sure Alvgar's like really, really close to him. Like, on, you know, one of those like bodyguard types, like rubbing up against him.
I'll just stand there and just
clean your axe or something while you're walking.
On my sleeve.
I'll lead him to Pythagoras.
Okay. So you lead him to, sorry, go ahead.
No, I was going to say, I probably don't get much blood on my sword with a bunch of skeletons.
Right? Yeah, not too much, no. But you might have a little bit of your own. Or Maple's, because she's probably splattering a little bit.
Yeah.
So you lead him to Pythagoras. Pi, you can see this simple kind of fat man walking beside Antimaeus. And he looks at you and says,
well, if he's not the master and she's not the master, this one certainly isn't. I'm not going to be dumb this time. So where's your master?
I'll tell him, I'll like whisper to Neil. Quick, Neil! Neil, you fool!
Okay.
And he like drops to his knees. And probably never having properly kneeled before, he like just does what he sees in, you know, probably stories that are told or books. And he just lays down, he puts his face in the mud. And his far out. And then he kind of looks up to you, Antimaeus, just like, is this good? Alright, put his face back down the mud.
I'm just smiling and I'm gonna like kinda talk through my teeth to Helen and be like, is this the village idiot?
She gets off the cart and goes, oh Jaunton, there's no need for that. He looks up and he goes,
oh, Helen, what a sight for sore eyes. You're still alive.
She says, yes, Jaunton, I am. You saw me run.
Oh, but I thought that maybe they had caught ya and cut ya.
There you go.
Sorry, that's not good imagery. I apologize.
And she goes, don't pay attention to Jonathan here. He's a simple man.
That I am. That I am.
And he kind of takes this like a compliment.
Well, Jaunton, what happened here?
Are you the master, if you don't mind me asking?
There's no masters, just...
He's very confused, but he just continues talking into it.
Oh, sorry, what was the question?
I nod to him.
Oh, he's just humble. Okay. So... Master, sire, lord.
It's just Pythagoras, Matthias, Alistair, Elric, the greatest hero in all the lands. But I was just wondering what happened here.
I don't believe I could explain any better than Helen probably has told you, but well, I'll give you my side of the old ass's whip if you know what I mean.
That would be excellent, whatever that is.
We was all sitting by a fire, food, to time, you know, merrymaking of the sort. And then, these conspicuous figures all show up in their black robes. And they says, hey, we ain't got nothing wrong with you, so you should let us camp on the side of your town. And you know, they had their swords quite heavily armed, so, you know, all right, I'm not going to let you know. Oh, you've got another pitchfork or two. So, not knowing better, they slept there. And the next morning, they all get up, decide they want to run the village. There's some of the fighting men, myself included. We get up and we say, no.
That's good.
Well, quite quickly, the blood starts shedding, and many of our folk fall. Their bravery, but you see, we ain't much for fighting. Normally, we're quite protected in this area, but not this time, I suppose. Then, they start chaining us up, but that's not even the worst part about it. They start chaining us up to take us off, What they do with the dead? Oh, my gods, that's far worse. They make them live again.
How do they make them live again?
I don't know. They just knelt beside them, and they stood.
That's fucked
up. I tried to say hello to Garrigus.
That's unnatural.
And how did you survive?
Oh, I ran an inn. I'm a smart one.
I see that. Are there any other survivors?
Oh, well, I believe rightly so. I mean, depending on what they did with the ones they took off. But, you mean here? I believe I'm probably the only one still in the village, sir. They were quite crafty, but I've got a mind for hiding.
Quite wow. Good. Wow.
Alias there's caught me a thing or two. He's a good teacher, he is.
Oh, you know Alias.
Oh, yes. Me and Alias go way back. At least like a month or so. It's been ages.
So you guys are lifelong best friends, I guess.
Yeah, too. Right, Alias?
I wouldn't go that far.
Yes, he's a funny fellow. Are we saying watch out?
Actually, you know what? I did hear a few stories about you from Alias, just saying, oh, my best friend, can't wait to see him once you get back here, miss that guy. Yeah.
That sounds like Alias, yeah.
Yeah, kind of
always the best trees in the wood.
Just gonna hide a smirk.
Well, this is disturbing. So, what should we do, guys? So there's nobody else in here, then? Just you, Jotun?
I believe so. I haven't searched it through and through, but I would think as much.
Are there any supplies left? I mean, we're kind of running low on a lot of stuff.
Did they raid everything? What are you supplying for?
Well, specifically for me, I'm looking for healer kits.
The only one that really did much of the healing was the old woman that worked in that shop. She was the one that made all of our clothing. She sewed up skin like she sewed up, you know, clothes. But I don't know if she really had anything of these healer's kits.
We'll have to go shopping.
Well, Helen, do you want to take a look around and see if anybody's alive?
Yes, although my main concern would still be with my husband-to-be. She looks at Jonathan and says, Jonathan, did you see Peter anywhere? And he says, oh, Helen, he stood with the men to fight them off, but he got chained up as he did. I told Peter, go hide, Peter. Come with me, Peter. Hide. But I guess he couldn't hear me because I was so far away by that point. And he didn't come. He got chained up and taken with the lads. Sorry, Helen. We'll probably never see him again. I'm sorry.
Yes! Oh, sorry.
She looks very, very upset. And she says, where'd they take them, Jonathan? Where? Oh, well, they took him that way. I think points over to the forest in the west.
Is that the same forest that hideous glob thing was killing us? Or going to kill us?
Like in the tower, you mean?
Yeah.
Yes, it'd be the same direction. I mean, southwest, yeah. But it would be that way, yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, it definitely did.
I guess we should have stayed and gotten eaten.
Well, it seems like you guys need to catch up. Team huddle.
Right. Helen gets adrift and walks over to Jonathan and kind of walks him away, and they start talking. You just hear this occasional, oh my, they didn't.
Indubitably. That's a pretty big word.
I don't know about you guys, but there's no fucking way I'm going back that way. That thing was horrifying. Who knows, it could even be chasing us still. Maple, I kind of explained it to you. I was in a real frantic. There was like a tentacle monster glob of flesh with millions of eyes coming out of a bubbling vat of blood trying to kill us. So
the
we
noise. Drank. The noise is what got me.
Yeah. I just blankly stare at him like, oh my god, but I'll just nod.
I'm gonna try and emulate the noise. Can I roll something for that?
Sure.
Charisma.
Oh, I got disadvantage on that too.
Yeah.
I rolled.
Also,
he rolled a natural 20, but his other one, of course, he takes disadvantage.
So and negative one, so 5.
Come and give me hugs. La, la, la. It was so scary.
Yeah, so like in his mind it sounds perfect, but when he actually executes, it's like blah 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 blah.
Isn't that scary?
Just not very convincing.
Well, these guys know.
It didn't sound like that.
I didn't
I'll
think
throw
it
that
would.
If we do head west, as long as we don't head back south towards that tower, maybe we'll be able to avoid it. And if we get there, we just keep going. Yeah. Instead of going back down that ladder.
I don't know, I kept hearing it in the forest.
Oh.
I swore I kept hearing it in the forest as we were going.
I'm gonna kinda go walk around Maple, like put him behind her, and then I'll kinda go up to her and I'll try to do that sound.
Okay.
3!
It's even worse!
Boogity, boogity!
I'm a flesh monster!
Seriously, guys? This is what you ran away from?
Mipple's like, sorry. I can't kill that thing on my own.
You don't know!
That noise can't be duplicated, it's that. Creepy.
Mine was better.
Can I roll like some type of like knowledge check to see if out of this description maybe I've heard of a monster like this before? Because
it should be the perfect imitation.
I don't know what I'm rolling for.
If you have any like knowledges or anything else, that would be helpful. But if you don't, then just an intelligence check.
Intelligence, okay. 3. Like from their description, I'm like, not a clue, guys. You're just crazy. Guys, sure you weren't just like seeing shadows down there or something? Was water running?
Oh no, it was there.
Fucking aliens jumped over me.
They heard, but as you're talking, you hear an exclamation from Jaunton.
Your right hand. Who's got bravery if not me, right?
Is he saying what I think he's saying? Is he gonna come with us? I'm all for saving people, but he's kind of stupid.
Someone needs to stay behind and be acting mayor until the rest of the...
Oh my god, that's brilliant.
GM's like, you want followers? You get followers.
He could watch the cart, keep our fires going, carry our bags.
I don't know if I can tolerate him.
Feed the dogs?
No.
No, I don't think we can leave them here.
No. God damn it. Fine.
Why not?
Antimaeus suggests that we all just split up, search the village real quick, and then meet back in town somewhere before we move on somewhere.
I agree. So, okay. I'm going to start with that old lady's place.
I will go
yes.
with you. I want to check that out as well.
So you all split up. Everybody can give me an investigation check if you have it, please. If you don't, give me a intelligence. And then once you have those, or one of those, give me a perception or wisdom.
6.
6 for intelligence. And then give me a perception or wisdom as well.
14.
Okay. And what do you do?
Oh.
24 for the first one, okay. Investigation, and 23 for perception.
Okay. Hi.
4 for intelligence and 15 for perception.
Okay. Maple.
13 for the first roll for intelligence, and then second one was perception for 21.
And alias. I got a 6 for intelligence and a 15 for perception. But I'd like to throw out there that I probably know some of these buildings that I'm going to focus on, so...
Okay, so all in all, this is kind of... You guys don't find anything that's crazy, like, you know, no hidden guys, black robes, or anything like that. But, so you do find 8 horseshoes in what looks to be, like, some kind of blacksmith or worker shops. If you guys want those, you can take them. They're just basic horseshoes, but, you know...
How many?
8. 8? You find 2 axes, probably meant for, like, cutting down wood. As far as, like, cloth and stuff, the place looks like it's been looted pretty much as well, but you do find enough to give you 4 more charges for one of your healer's kits. But all in all, the thing you guys are going to notice the most is that this village has just been, like, looted, and the buildings aren't destroyed, but people have definitely been most of these and taken a lot of it. And the last thing you guys will find in total is 3 days worth of iron rations for the whole group. So that's technically 15 days of iron rations. And iron rations is like leftover, like jerky and berries, that sort of thing that have been left around crates in people's homes.
All of my favorites!
Alright, so I guess once we're all done searching, we'll meet up again.
Okay. Yep, so you guys will meet back up again.
Well, it appears to be a ghost town. I found some more stuff, so did Maple. I really don't want to go back to that tower, but, I mean, if we can help these people, and maybe I can just close my eyes and swing, and maybe it'll die.
The wind, like, slowly blows the trees nearby, and you hear this.
Did you hear that, Maple?
That's what it was.
The wind?
No. You don't know. You just don't know.
Crazy.
Just such PTSD.
I want to roll an insight check on Pi just to see if he's messing with me now. Because at this point, I'm like, you guys are just making stuff up. 11.
Pretty sure he's genuinely freaked out, but how much of that is driven from, you know, lack of sleep?
Are there any paths or anything like that leading to the west that these people would have obviously left on, or...?
Yeah, so since you guys kind of search around the village, I'll give you some insight there. So, there's no road that leaves the village to the west, really. There is, however, kind of a clearing that people would traverse. And you, sorry, would actually be semi-familiar with it. While a road that you don't travel often, it was meant specifically for extra lumber camps back when there were more of them in this village. The demand for wood has increased. So,
okay.
It's kind of an abandoned road, but yeah, it exists.
Do I know it well enough that I'd be able to assure the group that the path does not lead back to the place where we came from? The tower?
You've never really had a need to go down the whole thing. However, it does head in a general southwestern direction. So there's a possibility that it might end up in the general area of that tower, yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to look to Helen, and I'm going to ask her the same question that the man in black asked about the man that passed through with a very unique woman.
No, I can... Well, not a man and a woman. There was a woman. Most of them had got that for too long. They came through the village not that long ago. Maybe a 10-day, if that. So maybe that's who you're talking about. She wasn't with a man.
And which way did she travel?
She was heading north. But it was really odd. She came to the village from the west, which no one ever.
Did we establish whether or not Helen has any skills besides a physician?
She hasn't really spoken to it much. When you guys had originally talked to her, she had kind of given the impression she was fairly helpless, aside from perhaps giving her a bit of medical aid as well.
Okay. Shovel Maiden 2.0?
So, yeah, I'll play bad cop and open up Pi for good cop, and I'll start going hard at her, questioning what good is she, and what how can she help. Just general intimidation.
Okay. Yeah, give me a charisma or intimidation. Yeah.
Well,
she kind of definitely is intimidated by it. She's a little put off by it as well, and she says, "Whoa, I'm not saying I need to continue traveling with you guys. You've done more than enough, and I understand that you don't want to risk your lives for our people. I would ask and potentially, you know, implore that maybe you'd help us a little more, but I'm not claiming to be of any real use to you. I'm not going to lie."
Whoa, calm down now, Antimaeus. Can't you see she's grieving? She's a widow.
And at that, I'll, like, throw up my hands and walk away. And be like, fine, you deal with her. You deal with her.
I give him a wink. I give him a wink and a thumbs up as he walks away. Kind of behind my back.
She looks to you, Pi, and says, "Is he always that abrasive? Thank you for defending me."
No, he's just a man on the edge. It's been a long, hard road.
Well,
do you need anything?
Your kindness won't be forgotten. I hate to ask more of you. You've already done so much, but I do love Peter dearly. Is there any way you could at least look into what may have happened to him and the rest of the villagers? I know Jonathan will probably want to see his wife again.
Well, I'm
so
sure.
Married him?
I'm sure we could. I mean, your husband's probably fucking dead. Sorry, but we'll try.
Thank you. I do appreciate it, and I'm sure that if you can rescue the village, they'll give you anything they possibly can to help.
I'm gonna like wipe a tear from her cheek with my thumb, like be all creepy and like, "It's okay, sweetie. Just go." we'll find the bad men. Yeah. I'm gonna give her my best Zoolander face too.
A little blue steel.
Yeah, a little blue steel.
Assassin's dagger just stops and then in all seriousness, she says, "You know, I'm just it's so overwhelming. I don't know what to do. And anyways, I appreciate the help of you and your fellows. I truly do. And while Jonathan can't really express it in words, I'm sure he does as well."
I understand.
And here's Jonathan, like, saying a foot away, "Oh, I surely do. I surely do." He's been listening all this whole time.
Look how smart his wife is. There's some towns that have two idiots.
So where are these people exactly? Like, just give me a quick rundown of where we should be going.
Well, I can do you one better, as Jonathan just cuts in. He picks up a woodman's axe you guys have kind of brought over and gathered. He goes, "I'll lead you there. Brave Jonathan is going to make a name for himself. He's going to accompany you brave men. Get the village back."
No, you fucking won't. No, you fucking won't. I will. Sorry.
But, under your guidance, of course, I would never take it.
Sorry, I didn't mean to snap.
I'll kind of step up next to him and put my hand on his shoulder and say, "Jonathan, buddy, I think it might be best if you stay back in the village in case anybody comes back, that they're going to need you to protect them."
Yeah.
Try to give me a charisma check.
I hope you've got more charisma than the rest of us.
18. Plus 2, so that's 20. Minus 10 for rolling with a poor die. Jonathan, so...
Even the 2 would have worked. You had to roll a 1.
That's embarrassing.
Yeah, I suppose someone does need to stay here just in case, don't they? Alright. Yeah. I'll stay here and defend the village all on my lonesome.
That's right.
Oh, they'll tell stories of Jonathan one day defending the village by himself. Nothing but his axe and the ground between him and his enemies. They'll call Jonathan. Jonathan.
And then he looks back at you, Pi, and he's like, "I mean, Pi, daggers."
And friends.
No, you're very brave, Jonathan.
Attaboy.
I'm looking at Helen. What is she? What kind of face is she making while this is going on? Because obviously, one of these.
Sorry.
She says, however, I would wish to accompany you. While I may not be good with a blade, I'm probably better than nothing. And I would like to be there when you get everyone back.
I'm okay with that. I mean, do you have any particular skills that we can make use of?
I might be handy with a bow. I've hunted.
My heart sinks when she says that. You just see it, a little tear.
I've certainly, never killed a person with it, and I've only killed a handful of animals, but they say I'm not a bad shot for what I've done, so if you have a spare bow or something, I could potentially do that. At least I would be in your way that way.
We did.
I rolled a 7 for insight.
Alright, what would you like to know?
I have this nagging feeling to not trust her since she showed up with an undead right beside her. So I'm just trying to see if she's playing Pythagoras, the fearless leader.
Okay. I wouldn't say playing. She's certainly not forthcoming about everything. Don't take it as if she's trying to manipulate or she's hiding something critical from you guys. But she's definitely a smart woman. And she's not letting on everything that she could potentially maybe know or talk about, is the impression you're getting.
Okay. Antimaeus will come back from his cooldown period, and he'll just look straight at her and say, I'm not sure you're worth it, and see if she responds in any way that would be unpredictable, in the sense, like, I'm expecting something like a sobbing, fake crying, rather than, like, a look of, like, bring it on, I'll fight you.
Yeah, fair enough. She turns and looks at you and kind of has a couple tears welling up in her eyes. She says,
well, many would not think village folk worth their effort and time, and if you're one of them, so be it, sir. She kind of wipes a tear away. But I'm going to go rescue my people.
I'll start clapping. And I'd be like, where'd you learn to act like that?
She turns away her face and looks back at Pi.
I don't see a ring on your finger for being betrothed.
Wait a minute. Yeah. The gears are turning. Hold the phone. Back the truck up. Give me a second. Does she have a ring on her finger?
Yeah.
I'm going to roll an insight as well.
But this is, remember, this is before De Beers told you you had to put a ring on her finger, so.
And a 1. I look at her cleavage. What were we talking about?
It could be wrong, but it almost looks like her breasts are smiling at you.
Well, they really want to be touched.
I hope I never wake up.
I'll continue and I'll say, what did you say your betrothed's name was again?
Peter.
Peter who?
It's Pumpernickel, obviously.
Pumpernickel, they call him Peter, my husband-to-be, Peter, the man who works with Jonathan at the mill. Peter.
Is he Jonathan's brother, perhaps?
No. Jonathan says, no. Peter's far too smart to be my brother.
I thought you said Peter died, though, Jonathan.
Oh, no. Peter took up arms, but he was taken off. He was hinged and chained and taken.
Shit! Well, I don't see anything wrong here, so...
Is there anything else about her attire or anything, Alex, that kind of sets her apart?
Give me an insight again. And actually an intelligence after your insight.
Sure. 16 and a 15.
No, she seems like a pretty simple farmer girl. If it is a ruse, she's good at holding it up. And maybe it's not.
Okay, Antimaeus will just stay behind her at all times, pretty much.
We don't have any bows or anything like that. I mean, unless you have one laying around somewhere. Unless someone wants to give up one. Just temporarily, of course.
Yeah, if you already searched the village, I doubt I'd be able to find any better.
Well, we have a whack ton of long swords. You can carry one of those for now. If you're any good with a sword.
I never fought with one before, but I can certainly attempt to.
Well, I'll show you how. Don't worry. I'll give you some private lessons.
Pull a Conan the Destroyer. Alright. So she takes the sword. It's, like, heavy in her hand, and she struggles to, like, hold it. And she, like, balances it with both of her hands. Okay.
This massive great sword.
I think I could get the hang of this.
I do the whole thing where it's, like, you know, when you go on a date and you're golfing, and then you go up behind them and, yeah, show her how to swing the sword.
Alright.
No, like this.
Like this.
You gotta thrust.
Alright, so you give her the sword, Jonathan just stands there with his axe, or he, like, starting to, like, patrol around the street, just ready for whatever's coming. Yeah.
Good man. Alright, guys, are you ready to head out? Or do you guys want to rest?
How far into the day are we?
It is not even hitting midday yet.
You can always rest on the way, too, right? Unless you want to have a sit down and I'll make some food or something.
Food sounds good.
Alright, well, kind
of. I can use some heals, so yes.
Okay.
Works for me.
Okay, so you guys gonna do a full rest then until nightfall, or what is the plan?
I guess we could rest here till nightfall and then leave and hopefully arrive in the morning to wherever.
Travel through the forest at night is always fun.
Yeah.
It's a dangerous forest either way, so.
It's dark anyways, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that works for me if that's what everyone else wants to do.
Is there any sort of tavern-ish place in this village?
Yeah, there is one building that would be treated as an inn. It's small, they probably don't get many people at it, but, yeah.
So we have it all to ourselves.
Yep.
Free booze. That's the cost of saving everyone who is currently in the village.
Saving the village, idiot.
Yeah.
Now sworn protector.
So I rolled 18 for cooking.
And we had grabbed the cart, right?
Yeah.
While Pi was making dinner, I'll get the horses fed and, you know, get them some water and whatnot.
So, as an FYI, this is roughly what the village kind of looks like. You can see that. So, this is south, north, and then I know it's backwards to you guys, but east and west. And so, this is a tree line. So, you guys came in from the south. You came around here. These are kind of like the muddy roads that lead to the buildings, that sort of thing, whereas this is the main road. And so, to the west, there's this tree line, and there's this small path that kind of continues down the southwestern direction. That is the path that that you guys would be taking. Just to give you some kind of clarity.
Okay.
That doesn't look too bad to take a cart along.
The cart it'll slow you guys down, for sure. It's going to be slower to take a cart than it will be to walk, because it's not built for a road to travel on, really, unless it was, like, a really heavy cart, so it's going to have to go over like, big roots and rocks and divots and that sort of thing, yeah.
What if there was somewhere we can hide the valuable stuff in the cart, and then we could leave the cart with our buddy here, but...
As far as the cart thing is concerned, are there any from, the woodcutting or anything like that lying around town, like heavier duty carts or anything?
Pretty much most of everything that was worth was taken, so if there was things like that, they are now gone.
Okay.
I would prefer to keep all the valuables with us.
We could always just go straight back the way we came along the main route back to that tower, whether or not there might just be a different entrance, or I don't know.
So
I've got a feeling there's probably another entrance to this place, but do we want to find that or just go back the main route to the tower.
Yeah, I'm wondering if there's, like, another path that branches off from going this way. Like, this looks like it probably leads down there, but what if something forks off, starts going north or something like that? Mm-hmm. I assume if there's a lot of people, we might be able to tell that at least they took a turn recently.
True.
But, yeah, I don't know. I just... The blob thing, guys.
So do you have any, like, tracking abilities?
Yeah, so I do have tracking, and forest is kind of my safe zone, my comfortable area. I don't know how this works, but I would assume I'd be able to figure out which way they went.
Yeah, I think if anyone can.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely have you lead the way then, for sure.
Yeah. And then hopefully we'll have a better idea once we kind of get following them. What we're up against.
I really don't want to fucking go back the way we came again. Because we did it once already because of my stupidness. And this time I don't want to run into that fucking, oh my god.
Well, maybe what I'll do while we're resting up and eating and stuff, I'll go just kind of walk to that path and see if I can get an idea of what went that way, how many people. And anything like that, do a little tracking, and then
you could
help us make a decision.
You could take one of the horses, maybe a little quicker.
Ride up a little.
Again, Antimaeus would be good to go along too. I mean, being sneaky and assassin-like and whatnot. I don't know. Maybe if you guys went and just took a little look while we sat back and got drunk at the tavern.
I'm game for that for sure.
I don't think there's any booze there, Almagar.
Yeah, they would have taken it all, wouldn't they? Son of a bitch. We'll make our own. Find some potatoes.
Some one-night hooch.
That's a good idea.
Maybe Jonathan has some stored somewhere.
Yeah, he knows how to make some moonshine or some.
Those crafty woodcutters.
Maybe he was smart. He just drank too much.
Maybe he's always drunk.
Yeah. And he's married.
Is he?
That's a shocking one for sure.
Yeah, either she's just a dumber. I don't know.
One of them's got to be stupider for marrying the other. It's just how bad does it get?
Yeah. All right, so I guess the plan is we'll rest. I'll cook, whatever. Alias can go and scope out the area. If Antimaeus wants to go, he can as well. Take the horses, it'll be quicker. And then come back and finish up the rest, I guess, and we'll leave at nightfall. I'd like to try and make my own alcohol, if I can.
Okay. That's How are cool. you going to try and do that?
With any food I can find, I guess. You know, like potatoes or something, I don't know.
Potatoes make
chicken.
Make a chicken beer, yeah.
Chicken hooch.
I think I'm going to take a horse and kind of go in a little bit. Okay. See if I can see if they branched off anywhere, get an idea of what's ahead of us a little bit.
Do you want to go by yourself? Or
do you want to take
yourself?
A dog?
Good with whatever.
Because I should rest.
I can send Chief.
Okay, I'm game with that. I spend a lot of time in the forest, so I'm comfortable either way.
We just need a dog to run back and warn us when you're dead, that's all.
Yeah, there we go.
Pretty much.
Tracking dog. Perfect.
What's that, Lassie?
Why do you got blood all over you?
A bottomless will, you say?
After riding for an hour and following the tracks, they still continue on down this path. Did the path fork off anywhere? They're just definitely heading southwest. Were there other options for them to take and they didn't? They just kept going.
No, they would have had to trudge right through the rest if they had gone off the path.
Okay. And that's quite a trek for people walking.
Yeah,
I'd imagine.
Yeah. That'd be at least, a few hours. I mean, you're not riding full pace because obviously you're trying to follow tracks, but an hour at your current speed is probably 2 or 3.
I'll maybe go like another half hour in, and then if
there's nothing significant, I'll head back. No, there's not. So, cool. I'll back. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So, yeah, this returns after a couple hours or a few hours.
Well, what'd you find?
Well, I went about X distance, hour and a half in, and there's definitely lots of steps. They seem to be traveling in single file for the most part. There's kind of at least six sets of prints that I can make out, kind of leading and trailing the group, but as far as how many are in a line, I could, who knows. But I would assume those are probably the villagers. So, but no forks leading off or anything like that. It's looking like we might find a tavern.
Well, shit. Would it be faster to take this route? Or should we just maybe backtrack again? God, I don't want to backtrack.
Could I gauge how... Are you saying that, like, distance to the tower, assuming this road goes there?
If I were to make a semi-educated guess.
Assuming that's where it's going, it would be faster taking the southern road because you can actually take the cart full speed down it versus this path where it's going to be, hitting potholes and going over bumps and that sort of thing. Yeah.
That's fair. So I'll share that bit of wisdom with the group, but then I'll also throw out there that, who knows, maybe it won't lead to the tower. There's always that chance. It'll take longer, but we might end up somewhere else.
Yeah.
Who knows?
Well, yeah, I think we should just stick with the plan. We'll take the west trail.
All right, so you guys are going to wait for nightfall to go?
Yeah. And I wanted to try and make that alcohol. I'm going to try and make it with, I got some rations. I'll try and make it with that. And I'll be doing it with Almagar because it was his idea.
You can call it Elm or Iron Brew.
So how do we do this, Almagar? Is this right?
Shoving potatoes into a bottle.
Put the lime in the cooker.
Okay, you get some things set up while Elias is gone. You do some things, some vegetables and fruits and that sort of thing. And you're like, yeah, this might work. Bottle it up, see how it looks in a week.
Success! Here you go.
Oh. Might have got a little peat in there, you weren't sure.
I don't know. Looks legit.
Might be a little cloudy after a week. Who gets to... Oh, I can't wait to test that now. We have to wait a whole week.
Nightfall comes, you guys get a full rest.
Are we, like, camping right now?
We're in the town. We're just probably in the tavern sleeping.
Oh, okay. I wasn't sure.
Yeah, I would have slept in the actual bed in the tavern.
Yeah, I assume you guys the building for the most part.
I want to look at that book again, that one that no one can understand. And I was just gonna spend some time with that.
Give me an intelligence check.
13.
So you're starting to find patterns. They still don't mean anything to you, but you're potentially finding common words or something because, you know, some of the symbols are repeated throughout the book.
All right. That's progress.
Is this book from before me joining?
Yes.
I will give you what you got there.
I got a book. Curiosity. It's a large one. And I'll show it to you. Do you know what it says, maybe? None of us can seem to read it. It's a curiosity.
Well, I'll take a browse and see if there's anything of importance to me.
Little does he know my history with books.
Do you eat books?
Nope, no. They eat her.
Zima's other characters have definitely had some run-ins.
Yeah.
That sounds super exciting. Cool, so I'll just kind of give a, I've never seen anything like that before. Where did you guys pick it up?
No, along the way.
Okay.
Probably have some dead bodies or something.
Okay.
Yeah, it wasn't someone else's property before we found it.
I'll just go sit in the corner and get some rest. I get it. Whatever.
All right. Okay,
So you guys get rested up. Nightfall comes. So you're departing.
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah, that's the plan. Right.
Okay.
Is the moon out tonight?
It is, but Alias will let you know that the forest is pretty dense. Again, you're going to need an external light source to get down that path.
It's all good. There's nothing creepy in the forest that would be attractive to the light.
Never. Never, ever.
But if you want, I can play my war drums for you. Scare everything away.
They'll never know where I'm coming. You get surprise attack on the I've got some torches, but Pythagoras had the better torch, right? Like the actual lantern type thing?
Yeah, I have a hooded lantern.
Right.
Yeah, we have a cheap lantern in group loot, too.
I'd be better than the big open flame torch waving around in the forest. Especially if I drop it to defend myself or something.
Okay, so you guys are going to light a lantern?
Yeah, we'll light the hooded lantern.
Yeah, the hooded lantern would be a better one.
Okay.
My oil.
There's oil and group loot. I don't know how much because we just got a whole bunch at one point. And then we started like throwing it all this and that way and all that. So I don't know exactly how much we have, but there's
probably got
a
couple. You got a significant amount. You probably got a couple days worth of burning oil for your lantern.
That's what I mean. Like, I know we had lots. We stocked up on that.
So I reach into my bag to find the hooded lantern. And suddenly something is glowing bright red.
Okay.
I pull out my hammer, and it's just glowing bright red for some reason.
Okay. So this would be something that everyone could definitely see. So, yeah.
What the deuce?
I pull out a hammer at the night. It's glowing bright red.
And it's glowing about 20 foot radius, a dim light, and an additional 20 feet from that. So it's glowing pretty bright.
That's an impressive pattern.
What you got there?
I don't know.
Is this something you found, or is it...
It was my hammer, I think.
Jonten, who is nearby, drops to his knees and says,
"It's a sign from the gods. Y'all be blessed."
No, Jonten, no. Go to sleep.
The gods speak true, even if you deny it. Pythagoras.
Oh god, let's just go. So we'll use this, I guess.
That seems to work quite well.
Yeah.
Hot?
No, it's not hot.
Just creepy right? Things might think twice before approaching that kind of light. This big beak and every creature in the forest just like drawn to it, attacked by like rabid squirrels and
dire beavers.
Can you imagine a dire beaver like the size of what a dire wolf would be compared to a regular wolf? Like
that
would be scary. Its tail alone would just like.
Okay, so you guys move into the forest. You start moving down the path. You're taking the cart.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can't leave that behind. It's got our gold.
Alright, Helen hops in the back. She's going to take a ride with it. And as you guys start leaving, Jonten starts following like 10 paces behind.
Oh, it's going to be like that sad little puppy dog. You got to go home.
Let's wait until we're actually out of town and like leaving like just into the forest. Then we, you know, he's still following. Like,
yeah, okay.
Start throwing rocks at him or something. stay.
All right. So you guys move like into the forest. He doesn't seem like he has any intention of letting up. He's still about 10 paces behind. He starts whistling a tune to himself. Jesus Christ!
I'm just gonna say, who's guarding the village? I hope somebody's guarding the village.
It's a good thing nobody's walking behind us, because there are ferocious monsters out there. And we wouldn't be able to save them.
He didn't seem to hear nor pay attention to either of you. He just continues on, just,
God damn it, Jonten!
He just stops in his tracks. Yes?
What did we say?
About what, sir?
We wanted you to stay.
Oh, but then you told me I could come.
Nope, that never happened, did it? Did anyone say you could come? Who says?
Your fellow there, he points at Antimaeus. He told me I could come.
I just give him the stink eye, Antimaeus. Son of a bitch.
I pretend to not see anything.
I'll just kind of sigh and I'll hop off the cart and I'll walk with Jonathan.
Okay, let's keep going.
You guys are all gonna die because of the sky.
Alright, so for the next couple days of travel, can I get a marching order, please?
Since we're moving slower, I'll kind of walk up ahead, since I know the forest well and I can identify if the tracks went off or any strange things like that.
I'll stay in the rear and I'll stay with Jonathan.
Roughly how many feet are you gonna be ahead? Like a ways?
No, like slightly louder talking distance away.
And Alex, can you clarify how many days? Because I would still like to roll to get hit points and dice back.
Sorry, I'm not making the days pass by quite yet.
Okay.
I just want to know what the plan marks.
Don't worry, you'll lose plenty more hit points before we get to. So, is Pythag, who has the actual lantern? Would Pi have it at the front with the cart, or are you driving the cart, or...
I just put that away because we're using that hammer.
Never mind.
I figured you could drive because you're good with land vehicles or something, right?
Me?
Yeah.
I don't think so. Well, I think Maple's got the animal handling.
That'd be me.
You're proficient with land vehicles, Scott, because you're a soldier or whatever.
Oh! Good.
He doesn't really think about stuff like that. He's like, yeah, I use them. Whatever.
Alright, then I'll...
Alamar's gonna drive the cart then.
Mm-hmm.
You're using the hammer.
Yeah, up front with him.
Okay. And you're sitting on the cart?
Yeah.
As well. Okay. Helena's also sitting on the cart. Maple, you're walking behind with Jonathan.
Yeah.
Okay. And then, Antimaeus, where are you riding?
I will be riding eerily in Helen's blind spots to the left and right of her.
Okay. Alternating back. You're the cart then?
Yeah.
Poor Helen, she's doing a lot of creepers.
And just continually whispering things at her.
Okay. Alright.
Tell the truth.
Sweet nothings.
Taste the rainbow.
My cat's breath smells like cat food.
So you guys charge along for a couple hours.
After about an hour, hammer goes out.
Yeah. Alright, so you're bringing out the lantern at that point?
Yeah.
Sorry, why did the...
I don't know, it just turned off.
Pythagoras, have you been possessed?
That's a really strange, out-of-the-blue question.
I can't help but notice that
personal
items seem to be glowing.
Well, yeah, I don't know. I really don't. I think it might be Alias. I think he's a ghost. He's messing with me. I trust him, though.
I trust him immediately.
Okay, so, Alex, you hear kind of a thud of earth. Exactly what it is. But, like, directly in front of you, this, like, dark splotch on the path is just there. And you're pretty sure you didn't see it before. And you're not really sure what it is. It almost looks like a really deep, dark shadow. And then, when you try to, like, lift your foot to, like, take a step back so you're a little surprised by it, you notice that your foot's, like, kind of stuck. on something semi-sticky.
Well, you think. The thud thud, did it sound like something heavy, like human corpses, larger, smaller?
Can I get a dexterity? Dexterity.
Well, that's a 10.
Okay. Can I get a strength saving throw?
No!
7.
Oh, God.
All right, you feel a sticky mass fly at your face. It kind of gets in your mouth and it knocks you off balance. You fall to the ground. A moment after, a big, hairy thing is directly above you, looking at you with all 8 of its eyes and its big pincer things. This looks like a massive spider.
Shit.
Damn spiders.
Well, leave him behind. It's too late.
Turn the coat around.
It's time to bravely run away.
All right. Almagar and Pi, I need dexterity saving throws from you guys, please.
Did we just find spider bandits?
Give us your money.
What was it?
Dexterity.
9?
Okay, what was yours there, Almagar?
With my big bonus of 3, it brings me up to 5.
We are all doing really well.
I'm pretty dexterous. But with sitting down, I've been stiff. I've been sitting wrong.
You were concentrating on driving the cart.
I stared at that horse's ass for so long. Dexterity save from you, please.
22.
Nice, okay. Almagar and Pi, strength saving throws, please.
Oh, my forte. Ooh, actually did really good. 17.
Okay.
18.
Oh, wait, sorry. 19. Okay. I'm a fighter. I forgot I'm proficient.
20.
From the trees, a giant spider drops from overhead and comes flying at Almagar and Pi. It lands upon both of you. You're not knocked off the cart, but it's right on top of you guys, essentially, and it's looking down at you with its eyes and its teeth. Another one jumps from the trees at you, Antimaeus, and you are able to get out of its way, but it does hit the side of the cart and kind of cling to it, and Helen lets out a scream. So, 3 giant spiders you guys can see. Let's get initiative, please.
Don't worry, Helen. I got this. 12.
11.
14.
It's 16.
Okay, that's my answer first.
I'll ride up next to one that's having fun with Helen. And then I will take a swing at it.
Alright.
15 to hit.
Alright, that is definitely a hit.
14 damage.
Okay. You pierce it directly through its abdomen. This kind of blacky purple blood comes out of it, and it just falls to the ground, and its legs curl up. Alright, I'm gonna...
Stabby, stabby.
Okay, so you're gonna run up to the... Alright, never mind, you're gonna have to run one on top of you. Okay, stabby, stabby.
You know what? Something like this would definitely make me rage, just because... Catch you off guard. Yeah, I mean, spider lands on me, I'm gonna be... Sorry, I'm not a... No, I'm a barbarian, but I'm a spider. 13.
Alright, that's a hit.
6. With a D12. Right. And lots of bonuses.
You hack at the thing, some bloody ooze hits you. As you cut it open, it lets out this scream as its mandibles try and, like, eat your face, and, yeah. Alias, what would you like to do?
This stuff in my mouth.
It's on your back.
Is it hampering my ability to breathe at all?
No, you can't see. I mean, you can kind of see, like, a big fuzzy thing above you, but not very well.
Okay, can I do like try and get it off my face with one hand while I pull out my dirk and try and stab whatever's on top of me?
Sure.
I'm assuming I can't pull out a sword.
No. Yeah, you can use your short sword, that's fine. Okay. But you will take disadvantage on your attack. But yes, the webbing does come off your eyes.
Oh! That's very nice. Okay, so my lesser of the two was 22.
Alright, that's definitely a hit.
Hit it for 7 damage.
Stabbing the thing, it goes... kind of gurgles on some blood noises, and yeah, still alive, but not happy.
But now leaking all over me.
Yep.
Cool.
How would you like to
do? Sorry, I forgot about Jojo. Is he incapacitated? Should I roll for that?
No, he can. I'm assuming that with the rest and that sort of thing, he's back up, so that's okay. Fine.
He's still back at the village.
See ya!
Oh shit!
So there's one on top of me then?
Yes.
Then I'm gonna kill it. And so is Jojo. 17 from me, and Jojo misses. 4 damage.
Alright, it is enough. You thrust your blade into the spider, it lets out this that curls over off of your bodies, and then legs just kind of curl up.
Gross!
Okay, Maple.
I am gonna pull out my short sword, and I'm gonna tell Jonathan just to stay close to me, but stay out of the way.
Alright.
And then I will move in, and I'm gonna try to hit the one that landed on the cart that Helen was screaming at. That missed.
It's actually already dead.
Oh, Anthony, that one is?
Killed it.
Oh.
Yeah, so the only one that's still alive is the one that's on top of Ilias right now.
Alright, well, I changed my plan then. I'm gonna attack that one, but instead I will pull out the crossbow.
Okay.
I'll hopefully hit him.
Oh, shoot us instead.
Alright, tick shot.
So 17 to hit?
That's it.
So that's a d8. Where's my d8? 5, 6, 7, 8 damage.
Alright. Bolt flies, hits the thing in the head. You hear this kind of sickening there, Alex, as it flies into one of its eyeballs, and the thing is going and falls over and then rolls up and its legs curling. Alright, we are out of initiative. Spiders be dead.
It's gonna kick that off of me.
I want to run up and reclaim my crossbow bolt.
Okay.
Can't waste
those. So successfully.
Awesome.
Alright, shortly after, though, you guys hear some kind of thudding and some of the trees moving, not too far away, and you kind of hear this shrieking noise, this squeeze, squeeze, squeeze from the trees.
Like a spider squee or an undetermined squee?
Similar to what those spiders were making, yeah.
Since I'm at the back, I am going to light myself a torch.
Okay, alright, you light yourself a torch. Okay, and again, trees in the distance, you can hear them shaking, and,
I think we need to move, guys.
I'm gonna keep
my last torch.
My weapon at the ready.
I'm gonna pull both of mine out.
Okay.
After kind of wiping some goop off of me.
Alright, double time it, guys. Gotta get it through here.
So, you guys continue trying to move.
I'm gonna put one of the dead bodies on the cart.
Okay. You try and continue on at a better pace. The cart is definitely preventing this. You are very, very slow with it. You get to a point where, you know, it gets stuck in a hole and you guys have to spend like 5 minutes lifting it out. Meanwhile, while nothing has come onto the road, the squeeing and shaking of the trees continues. It sounds like things are getting into the edge of the path.
Could I roll something to maybe know if the light is attracting the spiders?
Yeah, should you have knowledge nature at all? And if you do not, just give me an intelligence.
I totally have knowledge nature. I never even thought of that.
16.
Okay.
while you're not 100% sure on spiders specifically, light draws a lot of animals. However, the opposite can also be said, that you know, there are animals that see better in the dark, so it could be to your disadvantage not to have light, type of thing.
I'll light a torch and give it to Helen.
Okay. She probably takes it.
Let's go! I don't want to be eaten by spiders. I mean, I'll save you, Helen.
Alright, I need who, when the cart gets stuck, it's going to happen several times, who would be the people lifted out? It'll probably be at least a two-man effort.
Me and John Chong, because we're at the back.
Okay. Can you give me a strength check there, Zina?
Works for me. I'll just sit on the cart. Lift, please.
22.
Alright, with
oh lord! This thing's heavy!
You guys are able to get it out of the first hole. Screen continues. Nothing has jumped yet. Give me another strength check there, Maple.
17.
Alright,
let's go!
John successfully get it out of the hole again. Alright, another one happens. Things are starting to move onto the road behind you guys. While in the distance enough, they're in the shadows. You can definitely see many things scurrying and just kind of keeping out of the range of the light of your torches.
Small things?
Nope. They're about the same size as the last spiders, which is about the size of a person. But spider along.
Perfect.
Alright, strength check there, Maple?
18.
Alright, you and Jonathan managed to still pull it out of this this hole.
I'm just gonna start yelling at everyone, move, we gotta move, guys, move!
This continues on for quite some time. The road is getting rough and treacherous in this area. The thudding on the ground is starting to sound like rain, because there's so many legs just hitting the ground all at once, and you hear random calls from behind you. At the edge of the torchlight, you occasionally see several creatures kind of get into the light, and their eyes seem to kind of cower away from it, and they move back. The light does appear to keep keeping them at bay. However, if you were to make a guess on the amount of shadows you're seeing behind you, there's probably at least 20 to 30 of these things trailing the cart.
I'll have another torch ready to go to light it if any others start to dim at all.
Okay. It gets to the point where you're probably in the early hours of this morning, but there's no daylight yet, and you're at the point where you're either going to have to force yourself to stay awake and keep running from these spiders, or stop and sleep and take chances. What you guys need to do?
I'm going to take out that hammer and hope that it starts to glow again.
Okay.
And yeah, it's glowing bright white this time. And I'm gonna just fucking throw it back behind us.
And okay.
Throw it?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so you toss the hammer back at these things. Sure enough, it illuminates a hell of a lot more than 10 to 20. It's like the path curved a little bit, and it's just a sea of spiders going back.
Yeah. Holy fuck.
It hits one of them, and like a bunch in the front of the line kind of scatter, and all of them that were moving towards you all scatter into the woods out to go around that hammer. But you guys, continue moving on, and a little bit more out of the range of the hammer's light, they start scurrying back in from the forest trail.
Well, I think we pick up the hammer again, that's for sure.
Gonna go back.
You going back?
Oh my god, no. No fucking way. That hammer's a lost cause. Sorry. Some fucking creepy glowing hammer. I'm done with it. Let's go.
So, the one lighted thing that was keeping them away, we just threw it all.
No, we have lanterns and torches. So,
the spidery rain continues on behind you. It appears to the sea of spider has continued on. You are all feeling very, very tired. You're all at the point where you need rest. Do you all stop, or does someone try and push on the cart?
I hop off the cart.
Pushing on.
I hop off the cart, and I tell everybody, just keep going! I'll hold him off as long as I can. I'm gonna try and fight him off for as long as I can and then run.
I'm gonna grab you before you do that.
Too late.
No, I got it. No way. You have to run past me in order to do that, so I at least get...
I know you're tired, but it's still ready to give up and just go...
No way.
I'm gonna...
I'm gonna
torch.
I'm gonna take
not
a look...
Not letting you do anything stupid. You're a leader.
That sword that I took off that captain. Yeah. If that's doing anything. Thing else is glowing. I think it was in that little compartment or whatever.
So, Pi, are you still trying to run past Maple?
I'm trying, yeah.
Okay, can I get... If you're actually going to try and, like, overrun her...
No, I just wanted to run past her, that's all.
Okay, and you're stopping him?
Yeah, I'm stopping.
Okay, so you're not going to put up much of a fight if
no.
she stops you?
No.
All right. Okay.
We
so,
need
Scott,
to
you pull up
the
swords. No, it is not doing anything special.
I'm just curious if there's another one below, so I'll just put it back.
Alright, guys, what are you doing? You need two people to be pulling the cart out of the ditches. You need one person to drive it at a minimum. How many of you are staying awake? How many of you are going to try and sleep through this, if any?
Well, if anyone wants to try to sleep, I'll stay awake for a bit with a torch. And... Okay. Or we could just build a fire, if we are going to stop. I'm sure there's plenty of wood around here. We got some axes.
It's gonna be hard to sleep with a sea of spiders.
Yeah.
What choice do we have?
We're in the forest!
Yeah. We keep going, we're gonna start dropping, so.
I'll take you a knowledge nature check, please.
Yeah.
I wanna also do a quick look around just at our surroundings to see if this is even a decent place to possibly stay for the evening or morning.
Because we could make a big fire.
Yeah.
19.
I got 13.
Elias, now you kind of got a look at the behavior of these things. You're pretty sure you know what type of spider these things are. They don't like light, and they typically don't like daylight.
Okay. Well, I'll throw a little knowledge out there to the group and say, I think if we can build a fire fast enough and kind of hold them back, we'll be safe come daylight from the spiders. but who knows what'll come during the day, but at least we'll be able to get some rest.
Oh, thank God, I didn't want to run into a sea of spiders.
Alright, so you guys are stopping them?
I'll grab one of those axes that we picked up. And if someone wants to come hold a torch while I kind of cut some firewood here.
Do we have a couple torches going? Or
I have
had one.
I have one. We have the lantern going.
Yeah.
And,
I'll suggest to put like a little ribbon around
us. I thought Antimaeus lit one too, didn't you?
Yeah, I gave it to Helen.
Oh, we gave it to Helen. Right. Yeah. So we got a couple torches and the lantern going.
Okay, so we have a pretty big light circle.
Ish.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah, I'll yell at Jonathan to do his thing and chop down a tree. and let's get this sumbitch burning.
Yeah, there we go. He's got to be proficient in that.
He just starts whacking a tree. All the meanwhile. Genius cutting a tree. The spiders are right on the edge of the forest, and while they're being held back by the light, Jonathan is way too freaked out to cut down on the tree. So he just starts whacking off some branches and such, and he brings those over and he goes, "This ought to be good enough."
I'll probably cut too.
I ain't standing out there long enough to cut down a whole tree.
Are they big branches at least?
Yeah.
Cool. Well, I'll start
we'll give
getting
us a decent
so
start anyway.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'll collect some more bigger stuff while that's what we have once they get started.
Cool, cool.
Okay, so you guys end up setting up a larger fire. Your fire radius grows, which is good because your torches end up burning down. I mean, they've been going for a while. The lantern is still up from the oil that you have, but you guys do each lose a torch in this just by the length they've been burning. But daylight comes, and while it doesn't poke through the trees too much, it seems enough to dissipate the spiders away. A large troop, as soon as it starts lightening up a little bit in the area, disappears and dissipates back in the forest. and it becomes as silent as it was when you began your journey in this forest previously. But you're all very tired, very exhausted.
Aren't you glad you came, Jonathan?
Oh. I can't believe you're going to run right into the spiders. That's the bravest thing someone's ever done.
Sure.
They would have torn you limb from limb, eating your body parts one by one.
Okay, Jonathan, yeah.
Sectoplasmic
insides. Being the things that sleep deprivation does to you.
So are you guys resting?
I would like to.
Yep.
I would
everyone
take care of it.
Yeah, sounds
I'll
good.
Tell Chief to stand guard.
I'll just take a short rest.
And I'll make sure I've collected enough firewood to keep the fire going for several hours.
I'm just going to, like, rummage through my bag and see if anything else is glowing. Nope.
That was Taylor. We should send you back for that hammer. Well, the raven were going to the cart. It couldn't be far back.
True.
So everyone but Pie is resting.
I'm doing a short rest.
So, you guys all get rested, so each of you regain one hit die, and you can spend as many as you'd like. You probably also take one level of exhaustion, which means you will be taking a disadvantage on all ability checks.
Yeah.
So you guys rest up and continue on. It's just after midday by the time you're finished resting.
With my knowledge of these spiders, do I suspect they're probably just waiting in the thick of the trees till it's safe to approach us again?
Depends on how far they were from their nest. So if you guys can make enough distance away from their nest, they might not venture that far unless they think you were really tasty morsels. But yeah.
I think it was pretty tasty.
That was a lot of spiders.
I'll,
a lot of tasty morsels too. So.
I'll toss a couple good rocks up into the trees to see if I hear anything skitter away.
You do not. You just hear the rock kind of flutter around a few branches and then fall to the ground. Nothing past that. All right.
Are there any random cloaks hanging in the trees we can go check out? No.
We don't need any more cloaks.
Ooh, if we do.
All right. So you guys continue to travel on. Another night comes. You continue to travel. This one is uneventful. Nothing popping out of the trees or anything else. Since it's calm, are you going to take any opportunities to rest, Pi?
Yeah.
While everybody else is awake?
Oh, yeah.
All right, so you take your long rest. You lose the level of exhaustion you had before, so you're back to normal. And then you also regain a hit die. And then it gets to the point where early morning arrives again, and the rest of you, I'm assuming, will be resting while Pi drives again.
Yeah.
Works for me.
So everybody else, you regain a hit dice, and you can spend as many as you like as well.
While everybody's sleeping, I'd like to try and work on that rapier some more.
Okay, for sure. You're finding that pieces are coming together more easily for you. You get to a point in the road about halfway through the second day of travel. You're pretty sure that this road was going to lead somewhere near the tower until this moment, when the road takes kind of a sharp turn directly west, which is not cohesive with where the tower would be. However, it's pretty obvious to you, Ilias, that there was a big troop of people that marched on directly through the woods at this point. And that path continues on to the tower.
God damn it.
as well, all of you start to smell this very kind of pungent and not great smell. It almost is like rotting meat, but kind of also like cooking pork. It's like a mix of it.
Rotting villagers.
So it's not my shoulder.
No. Although here's my smell little. Or smell little.
cool. So I'll obviously call out that looks like who we were following kept going towards the tower that way, and not where I'd like to go down that path, which is not with all the other people.
I take it the cart's not going to continue to push here if we follow the towards the tower.
I'm going to guess no.
All right, Pythagoras.
No cart in the forest, Alex.
What shall we do with the valuables, Lurk?
So, to clarify, Alias told us all this, or Alias himself just knows that this passed a little?
No, I shared it with you guys. I told you.
Okay.
Alright, well, we'll leave the dogs at the cart, and I guess Jotun and Helen.
They should probably stay with the cart. I think that'd be the best idea. Rather than bringing more villagers into the nest of villagers that we're trying to save.
Helen says, I'm sorry, I didn't come with you this far to be left at the cart to guard your belongings. I will be coming with you. And Jonathan says,
Well, if Helen's going, I will too.
And shut up, Jonathan.
What good do you think you will do among them?
I don't know, but I'm not going to stand out here and die guarding your possessions when I've come here to help rescue my people.
We're just worried. We don't want you to get hurt, that's all.
Well, I'll look after myself, I suppose, then, she says.
Well, you're clearly not very good with a sword, and we don't have any bows for you.
I'll manage. I'll do my best. We'll see what I can do. I won't get in your way.
It's a very, very tall ladder to get down. Hope you're in good shape.
There are things of nightmares living down there.
And Ness will look at her and say, with what power will you use?
She kind of gives you this look like, what do you mean? My arms, I suppose?
Well, then lead on, brave one.
Oh, brave one.
Well, you saw the things we killed. We went down there, and it was a lot worse than what we've encountered so far, so...
Jonathan will say, Look, I'll stay at the cart. It's alright. I don't mind. I'll stay with the doggies.
No, you can come, Jonathan.
No, well, I wouldn't want to put you out.
No, you're not going to put us out. You'd be a very valuable asset.
The more the people that go down there, like, the worse.
Well, let's talk this out, because we're just going to get to the tower, look down, and be like, crap, we can't do anything. So, if we cannot deal with what's there right now in our minds, we can't figure out a way to kill them, there is no point in walking through the woods right now.
Was there... We had opened up that gate a little bit, right? We could have snuck under, but we went up this ladder instead, right?
Yeah.
We decided we could just go back down and just go straight through there and hope the tentacles don't get us before we're far enough away.
That sounds as good of a plan as attacking the spiders in the middle of the night.
Yeah, that was a long ladder. If that monster's still down there, it's gonna see us and it's gonna be waiting for us.
It's probably went back into its cauldron in the meantime. It's been several days.
Or it gone out somehow.
Yeah, like that open gate. I say we go to these guys first, deal with them, find out where the villagers are, and get more information. We know what's down that tower right now.
I don't think the villagers can wait much longer. I do believe they are priority right now than some... thing you got that's got y'all scared in this dark underground area. No, I don't know.
Yeah, okay, let's completely avoid fucking fleshy hentai thing and do something else.
The tentacle monster.
I don't want to get raped by fucking whatever that is.
Yeah, especially if your rapier isn't ready yet.
Alex, you said we can smell this rotten flesh, and so presumably they're relatively close. Could we perhaps not scout ahead, see if we can find their camp, and then make a decision?
Yeah, we could do that. At the very least, you know, if we stumble upon the tower, not go in. Yeah, no, I'm game to do that. Do a little scouting. At least find out what's around us. Okay, so you go down the forest path. Anyone want to come with?
Yeah, why not? I'm just thinking.
I'll go with you. We have to ride on the same horse.
I don't know how long it takes in the past, and I don't have the times written down.
I realize
okay, so
incorporating the
spell lists are useless. Right,
you continue down the path, like maybe a few minutes, and you can't see back the cart at this point because the forest is quite thick.
10 extra minutes,
but you definitely see the source of the smell. There are two people tied to trees and partially staked to trees, and it looks like they've been flayed for the most part from their forehead down to about their chest, and it's just been kind of let down to hang. So you can see exposed muscle and stuff and lots of bugs and buzzing around it and that sort of thing. The burning smell seems to be coming from their feet. They appear to have at some point been set on fire while no longer burning. You can see burn marks all the way up the villager's lower legs. There's also one dead villager on the ground that does not appear to have been...
Are the two on the trees dead, too?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Stand back, guys. I can save them. No, I can't.
are any of them any breeds?
They're dead.
I'd like to bring some good news back to the
how high up are they hung up?
Several feet off the ground, so they're like 3, I guess, feet off the ground.
So if we were to say land, we should I'm gonna hold on to the cart there so I can cut down the bodies.
Yeah.
Well, this is further into the forest path. You guys are gonna be hard pressed. This is where Ilias and Palmagar are.
Oh, I thought this was just like on the edge right there. Oh.
My bad, sorry.
I'm not there.
Are their feet still smoldering? Or.
No, it looks like they have stopped for a while. There's no smoke still coming from it, but the smell is definitely still prominent.
Does it look like all these footsteps and stuff we've been following still carried on through here?
Yes, it does. Yeah.
Okay. And then they've continued on.
And they just stopped this activity, whatever it was, and then
a little bit of wrecking.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, is there anything else that stands out aside from
beast sense?
The terrible activities that took place?
Animals.
Can you give me a wisdom or perception, if you have it?
Yeah, I should probably do a little look around, too.
Okay, yeah, you can give me a perception as well, there's stuff.
23?
Okay. 8. I'm not feeling very perceptive today.
Alright, Alex, you can tell that these guys did not stick around very long. Like, it really was just a stop and go. It also appears that there was some kind of a tussle that went on, and the biggest indicator of that is the dead villager who's not pinned up on the tree. He's like quite bruised and looks like he was stabbed to death, and it wasn't like a violent lie down and die. It looks like the guy might have gotten into a fist fight with somebody and then was stabbed.
Okay, so he had a very painful, frightening death.
Yeah, very much so. Maybe not as bad as the guys on the trees, but
different guns.
We'll have to make sure and show Helen this.
Fucking A.
Hey Helen, look what we found.
Well, I'll suggest that that we kind of keep moving and see if we can find anything else a little further ahead.
Okay.
Is there any indication that this happened recently? Like, within any amount of time I can tell?
Do you have medicine? And if not, can you give me wisdom? A
couple days, maybe?
22.
Okay. Yeah, Oliver is correct. A couple days.
Cool. Okay. So I'll suggest let's ride on ahead a little bit, see if there's anything else we can find, and then go from there.
All right, you guys explore ahead a little ways. The tracks continue on this path, but nothing else. Nope.
Do I have any sort of idea how far we might be from this tower area?
You'd guess maybe a few hours walking distance. Assuming this ends up with a tower, which you're pretty positive it does now.
The tracks are still going.
Ability. Yeah.
Cool. Well, I'll throw that out to Elmagar, see if he wants to go that far, or if we should report back and make a decision before getting to the end.
At this point, we should head back. I mean, if We're getting pretty close, so.
Yeah.
If we get too close, then we'll end up just going, too far. They'll be back there, and we'll be dealing with some nasties.
Cool. On our way back, I'll suggest, should we maybe bring the beaten and stabbed villager back? To see if they're recognized by Helen and Jonathan?
If thought there was trouble, we could just bring him back. Just...
Because it's just a couple minutes out from where we are, so.
Yeah.
So we found some people. Is this Peter? Let's not go this way.
you might not recognize the other two.
Yeah. Cool.
Yeah, we'll bring him back.
All right. So you guys bring him back. So Ilias and Almagar, after an hour or so, return to the cart. With them is a villager who looks black and blue and a little purple. And you guys just, like, drop them there? Or what are you doing with them?
We'll lay them down on the side of the...
Johnson walks up and goes, "Oh, poor Frederick. What happened to him? Did you just find him this way?"
Yeah. A little bit ahead of us here with some others that I don't think we'll be able to recognize.
Poor Fred. Freddy. He was a good lad, he was.
I'm watching her reaction.
Okay. She, she looks at him and says, "Frederick, poor man. He was such a kind fellow. It's too bad to see him in this state."
I got 15 for insight.
Okay. Well, she seems sincere about feeling bad for the guy. It's probably not as bad as she should for people that she's lived with. Maybe she's just a full-hearted bitch, I don't know.
Or maybe they're not her husband, and that's all that matters. No.
So after a moment or so passes for the villagers, I'll kind of share what we found. Yes, the path is definitely taking us back to the... most likely taking us back to the tower. And who knows what is waiting there for us now.
Well, they're waiting for people.
If they're waiting, who knows?
Why don't we send in one of the dogs? I can see everything they see.
What?
They won't even know we're there.
Even Almagar's like, "Whoa, that's cool." I just get really, really mad and smash
Jonathan
things.
Will speak. You can see you share your dog's eyes?
Yes. But he can't share mine.
And Helen will look at you and say, "That is a strange ability. How did you come to find that?"
Passed down by my ancestors?
The shaman of our tribe, actually. I have cooked a few lunches for him. He spoke these rituals to me. I have never actually... done them before. In theory, though, I should be able to see through either beast.
Jonathan looks to you and says, "Sounds like the work of dark ones to me, if you're asking me."
I wasn't.
And Helen looks at him and goes, "Hush, Jonathan, they're helping us. Be away from them soon enough."
Just a suggestion, though, guys. I don't know. That's up to you.
At this point, I think if we're going to go, we should just go. I mean, you could send the dogs in. I don't know. We need to see what's happening further in the dungeon. I don't think we can get them to go down those ladders, though. Just drop the dog down.
Climb, dog, climb.
Well, I only suggested it because my dog has the harness for his sled. So technically we could lower the dog down. It's just getting him back out. It should problem arise. That's all.
We should have enough rope between all of us.
Oh, we definitely have rope. It's like lowering the one thing we're not lacking.
It's like lowering a worm on a hook.
Was the pathway broad enough that we could walk the horses through? on their own.
Yeah, they could walk the horses through.
Okay, let's just pack up whatever we need and put them on the horses. If we're going that way, let's just do it. It seems like it's decided. We might as well just get there and decide who's going first and who's going to be hoisted down.
What are you guys packing up on the horses?
Gold, weapons. Obviously, I'll be leaving the three massive giant skeleton weapons behind.
Yeah, I think we just grab food, rope. If we have any water casks left, grab those as well.
Okay. So you guys take kind of the essential supplies then?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
You travel on into the woods. A few hours pass. No issues. Alias, you're leading through. You get to a clearing. The broken tower is there. The same one you were at before.
And we literally brought everyone with us, right?
Mm-hmm.
The tracks continue onto the tower.
Because we could tell them they can't come in with us. And it's...
Let's just send Dunton down first.
Well, honestly, if you guys insist on coming, we're going to
put him to work.
I think Maple thinks we're all kidding. Maybe she should go down first to just make sure we're not seeing things.
Or, it still sounds like you guys are a little afraid to me.
By all means, go ahead, all brave Maple the Barbarian.
If Maple goes, I'll go. But she has to go first because she needs to witness this firsthand. Watch me, nothing. It'll be like a little flower garden and a little fountain with some music.
Beautiful little shrine.
Welcome.
Did you say if I was able to tell if everybody went into the tower or they just kind of got to the tower and it was hard to tell from there?
How are you going to the top of the tower, like where the trap door was, to discover?
Well, yeah, we can kind of... I can't
follow tracks unless you're like looking at them. So are you going into the broken area of the tower?
I will very cautiously like look through, make sure I don't see anything in the tower first. Okay. Because he said we can see through it earlier.
I'll follow right behind with my weapon at the ready.
So okay. I'll see if I can get to the trap door. I'm not gonna open it or anything. Assuming it's closed still. Don't look at me like that.
You're fine. Yeah, you get to the trap door. The tracks lead all the way there, and they disappear out the trap door. So clearly,
and it's still closed. Almagar, you said you were following me.
Yeah.
I'll kind of shoot you a look and be like, do we open it? With my hand on my sword.
We might as well wait once. We might as well. You open it and all go at the same time.
For sure.
So I'll go in motion, everyone. You know.
While you guys are going off, I'm going to turn back to Antimaeus and Pi and be like, okay, what the hell did you guys see down there other than this tentacly thing that scared the crap out of you? What?
You'll see.
That's it. It was just a room with four gated doors. We tried to lift one of the doors up. We succeeded, and then immediately after, there was a bubbling well of blood in the middle of this room. And this fucking monstrous creature came climbing out of this thing, and it made the most horrifying sounds, and tried to eat us.
And many tentacles, and yeah.
Alias was so scared, he leapt over my shoulders.
I forgot about that.
We're not messing with you. It had like a billion eyes, bunch of mouths. It looked like people were sewn together.
No, I believe you guys saw something down there. It's not just you telling me, so I believe there's something there, but
I hear Maple getting cold feet. That's what it sounds like to me. All this talk, and all of a sudden it's like, oh, wait, let's think.
I just want to know what I'm getting myself into when I get shoved down underground somewhere.
I'm sure.
And before we go too, is everyone sure? Are we all sure we want to have these two with us slowing us down?
No!
We know that's all of-
No, they shouldn't be staying with our cart. They don't belong with us. And I'm actually really mad about this, and I just glare at both of them. I'm like, they're gonna get us killed. Or themselves killed and make this all for naught.
They're gonna die too, yeah.
Jaunton, under his breath, he mutters,
well, at least I'm not allying myself with dark forces.
He kind of, like, kicks at the ground.
I back away slowly.
Yeah, he clearly doesn't think he said it loud enough for anyone to hear, but everyone heard it pretty clearly.
He's just
still, like, kicking the ground, looking at his feet.
Talking loudly to himself.
Yeah, pretty much.
How did Helen respond?
She doesn't seem to pay much attention. She has her sword at the ready, and she's just standing.
I'm not going in first if they're going behind me.
Well, out of game, to bring an NPC like that with us.
Who cares?
It's gonna be... Yeah,
okay. We're gonna die anyway. We all know that. Have you not accepted that?
Maybe Almagar doesn't want to die underground in some...
Well, then what am I doing here? The only reason we brought this to is because they want to go.
Okay, realistically, how long has it been since this village was attacked and the people brought here? Are we looking like 2 days now? 3 days?
We're probably almost a week, aren't we?
Yeah, it's about a week.
Because it's 2 days travel to get to the town.
Yeah.
Two or 3 days to get to the forest path.
Yep. These people are dead.
Yeah.
Are we... really sure we want to go down here? We don't even know what we're facing. You're all terrified of whatever's down there, which is telling me this is a really bad idea.
I said it a million times, I do not want to fucking run into this thing ever again. I'm so terrified of this monster. First thing it's going to do is rape me, and then it's going to feed me to a hag. I know it.
I want to do a double take of this area while we're all talking. I want to search around just to see if there's any, other than our disturbance of the area, if there's any fresh tracks that may still have shown that, yeah, just recently, within the day or two, this area has been used. Because if this hasn't been used in a couple days, I'm saying all the village folk are all dead and I'm not going down under there.
So... the only thing to indicate that it was a couple days ago they arrived here were those people that were killed, essentially, which you determined was about a couple days ago. Otherwise, it's tough to tell from the tracks.
Could I roll a insight on Jotun to see if he's like a capable fighter, like skilled at all?
Sure, yeah, go for it.
Also, I'll mention the bodies to Maple.
9.
Do we leave those bodies by the cart? Do we take those back, or where did we put those?
I'm assuming we just walked past the bodies strung up in the trees.
Oh.
Yeah. We didn't have the cart with us to take them down.
Right.
Oh, shoot, I was going to ask Helen if any of those were her husband.
Right, sorry, I kind of jumped through that. They weren't easily identifiable. It was pretty much muscle on a skull. So, she would have shrieked. Jaunton would have been like, gods! But other than that, there wasn't a whole lot, okay. I think they're told. While not very intelligent, so probably not tactically minded, he certainly is a well-built man. He can probably swing that axe pretty well, light and hard labor and such. So, yeah, he could probably plunge an axe into something with relative ease.
I agree with Maple that they shouldn't come. However, looking at you, Jotun, you seem like you might be capable. However, Helen, I don't think you're ready. You're going to be killed as soon as you come down here with us. And I tell her to raise her sword and attack me.
Okay. She's like, I'm not going to swing my weapon at you.
Attack me.
No.
Show me what you're capable of.
She says, I'm not going to swing my weapon at you. This is hardly the time to practice swordplay. Why do you care what happens to me? If you're going to leave me at the cart for something to go kill me over there, what does it matter if I go down here and die?
swing your weapon. If you hit me, you can come.
No, I'm going either way. And with that, she walks over to the tower, and she props open the hidden trap door.
As she walks down the ladder. As she's about to go over there, though, I'd like to try and disarm her.
Just step on that door before she even lifts it. Okay, I'm gonna push her back.
Okay, all right, all right.
For this dead stare.
Just, no.
She says, "What do you care? Let me pass."
Because of.
Go down there alone. You guys can wait an hour if you'd like. And that way I can either be dead or gone. Whatever you'd prefer. Doesn't bother me anyway. The point is that I'm sure if any of you were in the same situation as me and people you cared about could be dying, you wouldn't want to sit hours away from where they could be dying doing nothing about it. Let me explain something to you. If these people are dead, I have nothing left in life. There is no point in me living if they are all gone. So what is the point of me being around if I'm not willing to risk my life to get them? And with that, she looks at you and says, let me open the fucking door so I can go down the ladder.
And as she looks at Alias, I would like to knock her out cold.
All right, give me a tackle.
Fuck.
She's gonna... Fuck, you just decapitated her,
dude. No.
No. By any chance, do I have advantage? Because she doesn't know I'm doing that.
Let me see.
Sorry, Elias, you're in the splash zone.
Yeah, you've got advantage.
Oh, awesome.
The splash zone.
Here's Maple.
Does 12 hit her? I'm not trying to, like, kill her. I just want to knock her out.
Give me damage.
6 damage. And with that, I have a bonus action I can do because of my Tavern Brawler feat. If she is still awake, I attempt to grapple her.
She is still definitely awake. You hit her in the side of the face, she wipes some blood from her lip, and you can go ahead and try and grapple her.
Wait, a little farm girl with 6... Wow.
Damn.
It was an unarmed strike.
If she really is a farm girl. Yeah.
Peter must beat her.
So that would be 22 then. 22 to grapple her.
Yes, you successfully grapple her. So you have her held.
I just want to say, just listen to us for a moment. We've all, well, can't say about Aunt Timaeus or even Alias, but the rest of us have all been in your shoes one way or another. We speak from experience. Only fools rush in.
We're skilled, trained warriors. You grew up on a farm. You go down there, you're going to die, and... If Peter is alive, then he has someone to mourn. Let us handle it. That's why we're here.
Okay.
You fucking bitch. Sorry.
Okay. Can both of you guys give me a charisma check, please? Both Pi and Maple.
I draw my weapons.
Okay.
Oh, both really good. Nice.
So 12.
13.
She goes, okay, fine.
I'll stay here.
And she just tosses the sword to the ground. And well, I guess if you let her. You still have her grappled, so I shouldn't assume.
No,
she just drops her sword by the side. She can at least do that.
Okay, yeah, I'll let her go if she seems to be calming down, not trying to trudge in down underneath into the trap door there anymore.
She's not. And as soon as you let her go, in fact, she'll walk away from the trap door. And she goes sit by some of the ruins of the tower.
I will immediately remove my foot from the trapdoor and
that was closer than you even wanted to get to that.
We're sorry, we're not... It's nothing against you, it's just... We're trying to look out for you. You fucking
just
bitch.
Go.
Sorry.
We need to get you healed.
Feel really off. I'm gonna take that sword she dropped.
So.
You want to leave it for her in case she wants to come after us?
I don't know about this chick.
So, how dark was it down there, guys?
It's dark. It's very dark.
Full dark.
Only one way to find out. I'm right behind you, Maple.
Great.
No, I'm not.
So, I'll get the old hooded lantern out again. We'll do the same old dance. Down into the hentai pit.
All right, senpai.
Not even mad about that.
I'm
his new nickname.
Well, guys, out of curiosity, you were down there. What ways, like, what direction does the tunneling go
straight
under there?
Straight down.
Straight down? But once you get down,
what direction?
It was pretty much northeast, southwest.
Right. Ranger knows.
Yeah.
So, from my memory of just traveling around the woods so far, is there a general direction above land, maybe, that might be worth going to versus... Like, would there be something, maybe, that this tunnel leads to somewhere above ground, just in the forest? Or did it look like it's just going down and in, like, some random direction to nowhere?
We couldn't really see where the tunnels were going. It was just, like, pitch blackness. But, I mean, there's ruins all over these forests, so there could be anything out there that they lead to, depending on how far they go.
Yeah, but if you were to pick a direction to go, like a door down there, we might want to pick west, because that's where the road kind of worked off.
Oh, yeah, the road was leading.
If we want to make a guess and just pick a direction, that might be the...
Is that the gate that we opened? I think we picked the western gate, wasn't it? I could be wrong. Does anyone remember?
It was just a random... There's a gate, open it. I don't remember.
It was the eastern one, I believe.
Oh, okay.
All right, well, if you guys are ready to go, we might as well get this over with.
I'll go in the middle this time, not first.
You don't mind going first, Maple?
I don't think this thing's...
Actually, once you open the door, I'll take a good listen and see if I can hear anything down there. Before we go down there.
Just stick your head in the hole.
Yep. I rolled a 15 to perceptive I am in the dark.
While he's doing that, I'm gonna spend a moment with Chief and just be adamant with his you watch her and his
JoJo's there, yeah. He can't go down the stairs anyways. Okay. Or I mean the ladder.
Okay, yeah. you stay with them. You watch them. Guard.
You stick your head in there. Sounds dead silent, and it's just pitch blackness. Exactly the same way as it was when you had first...
Alright, so I'm thinking our little friend is retreated into the cauldron of blood and is awaiting us to awaken him again.
Oh my god, I'm dreading
Shall
this.
We?
So dreading
Nobody this. Look in the blood this time.
At least the gate's probably still open.
Also, after I finish giving Chief his orders, I want to quickly just run over to Helen. And, Alex, I'm going to send you a text message. But okay. I will be really quick.
Yeah, no worries. You can also message me on Skype if you're okay with Pi seeing it, or if he looks away or whatever. But text, whatever's easiest.
I'll look away.
Do not care.
But yeah, then I'm just going to head back to the group, and then we'll head in.
So I guess Maple's first.
Okay.
I'll go behind her, so I'm technically in the middle, I guess. I don't know.
Is Jonathan coming with us, or do we decide he's staying up top?
No, he can come. He looks capable.
Okay, just make sure he doesn't say a goddamn fucking word because he's loud.
With that, with this discussion going on, he's like, I'm not going anywhere with dark ones that hit innocent women. I'll stay up here with her, as he points.
Perfect. Off we go. Now we might be able to make some progress and save these villagers, says Almagar in game.
Well, good for you, Jordan. You're a brave man. And I give him a cookie.
That I made with some iron rations I made. There might be some chicken in it.
How long did it take us to get here?
A couple days.
From the village?
Yeah.
A few days, yeah.
So would that booze be ready?
Look at it if you want.
Take a sniff.
Sure, I'll take a look at it. But what?
Wonderful. Future and wonderful all at the same time.
You know what? I'm going to take a big swig because I'm probably going to die.
Okay. You drink, like, pure alcohol. Okay. And, all right. So, Maple's going first. Pie, you're second.
Yeah.
Okay, who's up third?
I'll go third.
He's coming behind me with
who's
a light.
Fourth? I'll go next.
You got a light?
Who's holding the light source?
I am.
Okay. All right. So you guys get on the ladder and go on down.
I'm going to hood it again like I did last time.
So it's slow going again. You move down this ladder. After, you know, 10 or so minutes, you've made it the several hundred foot drop down to the bottom. You are in the large circular room again. There's a door at the north, door at the south, door at the east, door at the west. And by doors, I mean they're just essentially bars. They don't have a handle or anything else on them. There is the large basin in the center of this circular room that is filled with a dark liquid. You still see the large sun engraved that almost takes up the entire circular area of the room.
Is that gate open?
No.
So they're all closed now?
They are. They're all closed.
I'm quite sure someone has been by since the last time we were here.
Another thing you'll note is that, remember how there were like bloody footprints walking up to the basin previously?
Yeah.
Those are gone. However, there is a little bit extra blood splatter at the base of the basin, which was not there previously.
So I'm gonna pull out my weapons.
Let's go about this very quietly this time. Like, super quietly. Yeah. Which one should we go through?
West.
West?
I think so, yeah.
So, let's do this again. All three of us is trying to open this thing quietly.
Is there a lever or something?
And if we can get through, even if that thing starts bubbling out, just get through this door and just go.
We'll face that.
Yeah, we can close the gate behind it, I guess.
If we can close it behind us, yeah.
Maybe, yeah.
All right, let's do this. Cool. Maple, you want to give me a hand with the door? Anyone someone else?
Throw the barbarians at it.
Okay, so you guys going to the east door again?
West,
sorry.
You know, I didn't have a really good grip on it. That's 8.
You gonna make me do this by myself?
Well, after all your sniveling about this place, I don't know, guys.
19.
10 from me.
Okay. Scott, you're able to get it barely off the ground, but without a whole lot of extra help, it doesn't go much farther than that. The thing in the center starts to bubble, and you start here.
Damn it.
Fuck, everybody fucking open this gate now!
Everyone to the door, everyone left. We're all into this.
Better.
Not into it.
Okay, I guess we'll try again at the door.
Guys, as tentacles start coming out of
13.
Power lift.
13.
Natural 20.
Oh fuck, yeah, you were just like,
not again!
I'm pretty motivated this time.
Alright, you got a natural 20. Did anyone get a natural fail?
No.
That one? No, okay. Alright, so,
Scott, you or Almagar, you're just like, nope! And you raise the door, and yeah, you get it just high enough for all of you to kind of sneak under. If you so.
And if, as soon as saw that going, does the door close behind us? Or
no, it stays. There is, however, a lever on the other side that you can release that opens your
door. Oh, I'll hit it as soon as I'll just. Yeah, I'll check.
And the door goes. And stops. And louder from the central room, you hear the.
Run! I'm way ahead of
that
guys.
Sound, people. That sound. Yeah.
So now that I hear that sound.
I know, it sounds just like it, right?
You guys sounded nothing like that.
Well, I was close.
No, I don't think we could have tried. That's why we anyway, shall we keep moving?
Run.
Yeah.
Yeah, we
obviously we should make sure we can see where we're going, but
you got the lantern.
Yeah, I got the lantern.
Anybody see anything up there?
Do I see anything?
Yeah. Okay, so you guys are in kind of a stone hallway. It is more or less blank for where you're standing right now. You cannot see the end of it with your current lantern.
Do we know?
Continue.
Sorry. Not a one, just cool. A stone hallway.
I say we shuffle somewhat quickly.
Yeah.
But I have the floor though, too, as you go.
Yeah.
Do we hear that thing?
Oh yeah, you still hear it echoing from behind.
Is it like getting louder at all? Or...
Oh yeah. In fact, looking back, as you guys are kind of looking around, slowly moving down the hall, it's pressed up against the bars and it is slowly sneaking its vortex.
Fucking run! Oh my god!
Right now?
Any
extra
one? Yeah, I got one.
We can smash it. After everyone runs through, light it. And
toss the oil to Maple, and I just book it.
And hope Maple catches it.
You can't book it. You got the lantern.
Oh, right, yeah. So toss it to Maple, she does the plan.
I'm like right behind, like, what are you doing? Just calm down for a second.
Gently handed.
You haven't seen this thing.
I pour out the oil on the ground and be like, come on, everyone, keep going!
Okay.
And then light it.
Yeah, grab my...
All right, my tinder. Toss oil on the ground behind you, you light it, you guys are gonna keep going.
Yep.
Yes. There's no turning back now.
Pie just and, down, Maple, could you please give me, just d20 rolls?
No.
Each one.
Just
d20? Yeah,
it's
just d20.
16.
Okay.
Here comes the one, everybody. Ready? 12. Okay.
All right. No, you guys continue on. However, you do hear a distinct noise different from the from back down the hall. You hear a loud thud followed by a very short and sharp yelp. This happens twice.
Bitch!
That fucking bitch. Oh, if she killed my dog, she's done.
I'm not protecting her.
That'd be awesome if it was he fell down the ladder.
The neck out of him.
He's a little going.
Well, we're fucking running anyway.
I don't think we're going back that way. All right.
Are we able to identify the yelps as possibly canine?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they sound like
fuck!
Okay, you guys can see it running down the hallway. As you're halfway down the hallway, you notice there is a door. It's another about, like, 60 feet in front of you. This is a long hallway. The stone is starting to become more ornate on the walls and the floor. The floor is a pattern of these suns just going forward every about 5 feet or so. On the walls are many different pictures and images depicting several what you would guess to be
potentially gods or figures of power, just by the way they're carved, looking over large cities or strangling someone else or bludgeoning someone in the head or a bunch of very graphic depictions of really horrible acts.
Are any of these images familiar? Like, do they look like gods at all that I might know of?
Do you have religion at all?
Yeah.
Okay, give me that religion check.
God damn it. 8.
Okay. Luckily, you had already seen this god on the tower above, so it doesn't take a lot for you to know. His fight here in many, many situations.
This bitch again.
In several of the carvings, you see a sun emblazoned across her chest. She's generally the one committing acts of atrocity, sir.
And she's just, like, slaying a bunch of people? Oh, okay. Is this room, like, a big circular room, or...?
No, this is still just the hallway.
Oh, it's the hallway.
These are all on the walls, yeah. So at the end of the hallway, there is a door. But, not quite passed through yet.
I look at Antimaeus and go, do your thing.
You look for Antimaeus. He's not there.
Antimaeus? Antimaeus?
Huh.
Fuck.
What kind of door is it?
In the commotion, did we notice him come through the gate with us?
No.
Oh. Anybody sneakies.
What type of door is it?
It is a large stone door, but you can clearly see hinges on it that would probably assist its opening. So it is meant to be opened.
In or out?
It will open towards you.
Alright, guys. We open this, or are we going through, or do you...
I don't want to fight what's behind us, so...
Yeah, let's open the door.
Slowly you're acting down the hall. Sounds pain.
Well,
more pain? Sounds like it's eating.
Yeah, I'll open the door.
I'll open the door because you got the light.
Oh, okay.
Right.
And yeah, I'll be harnessing up my weapon at the
ready here. Okay, everybody's got the weapon ready. Okay. Maybe you grab this heavy door and use... get open. What you see is actually a lit room. There are torches burning in here. You see several corpses on the ground, their entrails strewed all about the floor. This is a smaller, much smaller, but still circular room. Opposite the door, there is a dais, and at the dais are four people in dark black robes. All were kneeling before the door opened. They turn to look back to you and draw crooked blades.
Two questions.
Yes.
What's a dais?
Yep. A dais is sort of an altar-like thing. So typically it has like a couple steps up on like a stone platform.
Okay.
Like never go up on a platform.
The dark robes, do they resemble the dark robes from the two guys?
Oh yeah, they've got the big white sun across their chest.
Okay.
And they stand there with curved daggers drawn.
For it to fight with?
To the right of the room, so this is directly across from you. To the right of the room is a man also in this dark black robe with a white sun upon it. However, in the center of the white sun is a white flame. He says... more for the harvest. And he starts to speak words that are essentially gibberish to you. And that's where we'll leave the session.
Oh.